I'm Doug Parker with Cruise Radio, and this is a tour of Princess Cruises, Majestic Princess. Before we get started, if you'd like to jump to a certain deck on this ship and you're watching this on YouTube, just see the timestamps below. Majestic Princess carries 3,560 guests. It comes in at 143,700 gross registered tons, 1,083 feet long, and has 19 decks. The ship entered service in March of 2017. She was originally built for the Chinese market and cruised seasonally from Shanghai and Australia up until the cruise industry shutdown. Then in July of 2021, Majestic started sailing Alaska and the Mexican Riviera. And as November 2021, she is scheduled to return to Alaska in May of next year. Now, let's jump right in. You embark the ship on deck 6, but we'll start on the first guest deck, which is deck 5. Deck 4 is technically a guest deck, but is only used for the medical center and embarking and debarking in certain ports of call. All right, we'll start at deck 5 forward, and that's where you'll come across the Lotus Spa. Now, in here, you'll find treatment rooms for massages, nail and hair services, as well as the thermal suite. That's called the Enclave on the ship. The Enclave is its own area right here in the middle of the spa, and it has a mineral pool, 3 heated rooms, tile loungers, and an aromatherapy shower. Now, you can buy a thermal suite pass for the day or for the week, but just remember, this area is capacity controlled, so they'll only sell a certain amount of passes per week. Now, just opposite of the spa, used to be karaoke rooms when the ship sailed back east, but since repositioning to North America, those karaoke rooms have since been converted into treatment rooms. Coming out of the spa and walking aft, you'll come to the guest services area and the shore excursion desk. Also in here, there's a specialty restaurant called Harmony. That's an Asian fusion type restaurant. You'll find dishes in here like sweet and sour pork, spring rolls, wonton soup, wok fried lobster, which was really good, and other Chinese dishes. Now, if you're familiar with the Princess brand, this was the space where the Italian restaurant Sabatini's was located, or is located rather, on the other ships. This is one of those food changes that was made to the ship since it was launching in Asia. And like Sabatini's, this is also a specialty restaurant that'll cost you an extra $29 per person. From here, you'll walk into the piazza. You could say this space is the heartbeat of the ship. It spans 3 levels, and on this deck, you have the International Cafe, which is where you could get small eats and different types of hot beverages throughout the day. And just opposite of the International Cafe is the Vines Wine Bar. That's self-explanatory. And you'll also find a lot of shopping in this space. Now, just after the piazza, or the atrium, here on deck 5, is the Symphony Dining Room. This is one of the 3 main dining rooms on this ship. The others are Allegro and Concerto. This is your typical cruise ship dining room, and it serves a different menu every night, ranging from seafood to steak to veggie options. Up to deck 6 aft, you'll find the second main dining room called Allegro. Like the one on 5, it's another main dining room option, but this is where things get interesting, and if you don't know your way around the ship, you could get lost. Now, since there are 2 dining rooms on this deck, the kitchen is right in the middle of both dining rooms, so it is not accessible to guests. So if you're walking out of the dining room and you want to access, say, the piazza, you'll have to go back down to deck 5 or up to deck 7 and walk forward, because remember that kitchen anchors those 2 main dining rooms and it's not accessible to guests. Just ahead of the kitchen is the 3rd and final main dining room called Concerto Dining Room. Walking forward from this dining room is the art gallery and photo gallery on the port side, and just opposite is Alfredo's. Now, Alfredo's is a complimentary venue that serves pizza and light Italian dishes. I highly recommend the pizza here. The service is quick, and you can be in and out in 30 minutes if you like. It's a really good place to stop after you've been touring for a day. You embark the ship and grab you a quick slice or a whole pie, whatever you want to do. Surrounding the piazza atrium here, you'll find another bar called Good Spirits. Keep walking forward and you'll head right into the gaming area. The Grand Casino is set up from the midship to the starboard side, and there's a VIP gaming room on the port side. Now, the VIP gaming room, if the area looks familiar, on other ships, it's the Take 5 Jazz Bar. Smoking is allowed in the Grand Casino, and there are filtration machines. I noticed that they're positioned throughout, like strategically placed throughout the casino, and I have to say, they do a pretty good job at pulling out the smoke, and also there's doors going into the casino, so it does stop the smoke from drifting into the piazza atrium area. Now, the Princess Theater spans 2 decks, and just outside of the casino is the lower level to the Princess Theater. Here they have nightly performances on board, comedians, and those welcome aboard shows. Up to deck 7 and exiting the theater is where you'll come to more shopping on both sides of the ship, followed by the Ocean Terrace Bar. This is a good bar to go to if you'd like to overlook the entire atrium. Right next to the Ocean Terrace Bar is the French Bistro Onboard. It's a sit-down specialty restaurant for $29 a night. They have some pretty good food here if French is your thing. Not a big fan, more of a meat and potato guy myself. The food was okay for me. I know I'm doing a really bad job selling this place, but it's just not really for me. But if you like French food, you're going to love it, I'm sure. Now, walking towards the back of the ship, you'll come to the area where you can customize your Ocean Medallion token. The prices are decent. I picked up a watch band for mine. It was $12. Other guests had bracelets, necklaces, and other apparel. Opposite of the customization station, you have the Princess Live Cafe, where they have coffees and drinks. You'll also notice a little theater here as well. It's a mini theater, we'll say. It's called Princess Live. This venue is where the late night comedy shows are held, the game shows, culinary presentations, and live like tribute concerts and things. Walking aft, you'll come to the Crown Grill Steakhouse. This is Princess's steakhouse. It has that nice 22-ounce porterhouse steak. And for $10 extra, you could throw in a lobster tail to that steak if you don't want to do the normal small 8-ounce surf and turf. If you like to eat like myself, just outside of the Crown Grill, there's a bar with a nightly piano player. Heading aft, you'll walk through the library, and then to the very end of Deck 7, you'll find the Vista Gaming Lounge. But don't let that name fool you. It's just another theater slash lounge, another dedicated space here for shows and music. On our ceiling, they actually held the art auction in here, trivia, and quizzes. If you want to step outside and get some fresh air during your sailing, this is the space to do it right out here on the Vista Gaming Lounge. There's a couple of doors to both port and starboard side. As you make your way around the atrium, too, you could go outside and enjoy some fresh air. Decks 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14, and 15 are all guest decks with a variety of cabins ranging from inside all the way up to suites. And while we're on the subject of staterooms, mine was on deck 12. And it's classified as a mini suite, which meant more square footage inside, but the balcony size was about the same as your standard balcony cabin. Also, Princess does have a ton of closet space, which was a nice touch. Up to deck 16 aft, we'll start at the Wakeview Bar. This is where you can overlook the back of the ship while eating food from the World Fresh Market Buffet or enjoying a drink. The buffet just inside these doors is made up of two identical areas in the forward and aft area, and it's anchored right in the middle by this really nice bakery where all these desserts can be found. Now, take note that this was filmed during the cruise industry restart with limited capacity, so a lot of these areas aren't open yet, but I can tell you from being on a handful of the past Royal Class ships, the buffet in here is really, really good. Now, as far as poolside venues, you have the ice cream just outside of the buffet area, and you also have two eateries by the pool. You have Chopsticks Noodle Bar on the port side, and you have this burger bar just opposite of there. It also serves lobster rolls. They're $15 a lobster roll, and that's the only four fee, F-E-E, item on the menu out here. Everything else is included with your cruise. The two food areas are anchored by the middle fountain pool bar. This pool area is really nice out here because it has two different pools, sort of. They are connected but can be accessed from either side of the Lido deck. Also, the middle has a fountain area type thing at nighttime where it comes up and does the lighted thing. Kind of like a mini Bellagio, I guess. Another signature Princess activity is movies under the stars. This is where throughout the voyage, day and night, they play movies on the big screen. By day, it was a lot of musical programming. The one I noticed was like Shania Twain in concert from Vegas. One night, they played the movie Bohemian Rhapsody. If you're looking for stunning views and have the chops to do it, they have the Seawalk area on the port and starboard side of the ship. This goes out 28 feet over the side of the ship and 128 feet above sea level. So the floor is basically translucent, so you're literally walking over the ocean. It's a pretty cool experience. Also, there's a bar to one side of the Seawalk as well. Now, just forward of this little pool area is the elevator bank, and then more staterooms forward from here. Up to deck number 17, aft is where you'll find a gym. This is your typical cruise ship gym with the treadmills facing east to west and those strength building machines. Also, a dance studio is in here as well. The kids and youth areas are also located back here. There are two different sections. There's one for the little kids camp Discovery. And then you have the Beach House Teen Lounge, which either of these were open when I walked by there. So not sure if it was because of the, you know, lack of children on board or if it was just kind of off hours. But anyway, here's some photos. Another outdoor deck area is located just after the gym. This is a smoking spot on the ship where guests are permitted to smoke. And just below the stairs, it will take you down to deck 16 where the Wakeview Bar is. And then again, the buffet is located just inside the doors down there. There's a walkway connecting the forward and aft area of deck 17 that walks right above the Lido pool. If you keep walking forward, you'll come to the Hollywood Pool Club and Hollywood Observatory. The pool is a solarium-type pool, and unlike other ships in the Royal Class, the roof is not retractable. but you will find the pool, two hot tubs, and a bar out here. Keep walking forward. You'll come to the Hollywood Conservatory. This is very nice. It makes this the perfect ship for sailing Alaska because of the observation deck with basically a 270-degree view from the very front of the ship. If you're familiar with the other Royal-class vessels, you'll remember that this is the sanctuary on those, kind of an adult retreat area. While they did have cabanas in here, I didn't see anyone rent them on our sailing. There was no cost to enter, so it wasn't like an exclusive area up here in the Hollywood Conservatory. Up on deck 18 is the Princess Sports Central with the basketball court, light workout equipment, and a track area. And finally, deck number 19, the sky deck. The highest deck of the cruise ship, actually. You couldn't get any higher unless you were being medevaced off the ship, and we don't want that. You have miniature golf up here. Also a really good spot to, if you want to take in the stars at nighttime, basically no light pollution from as high as you are up here. Okay, that'll do it for our tour of Majestic Princess. I'm curious, what do you think of the ship? It was interesting. It was a nice departure because I'm not really a big sun person, so the Hollywood Conservatory was very nice. Also, the Ocean Medallion program, which you approach your stateroom door and the Ocean Medallion would unlock your door, not open it for you, but it would unlock it. You could also order food and drinks from anywhere on the ship and super fast Wi-Fi. Now, keep in mind, we were sailing at about 50%, so that could have an impact on how fast our speeds were. So the true test is when things are back to normal again, whenever that may be. All right, my name is Doug Parker. I'm the host of the Cruise Radio Podcast and Cruise News Today. If you want to see more ship tours, we have dozens of them on the Cruise Radio YouTube channel. If you like the video, give it a like. It's the best way to say thank you. I know your time is valuable, and I sure appreciate you taking a couple of minutes to check out this video.
The proceeding was a production of Cruise Radio. For more accurate and dependable updates, subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit cruiseradio.net.